Hello everybody, it is your boy TwinPlays here, back in another video. Hope you guys are doing amazing. So recently we left off with another tutorial, and today we are back again with another cafe tutorial. Now this is going to be the cafe boards, as you can tell by the title. And yes, you guys, I did fix the other one and it should be working just perfectly fine. But these are two boards. We got a teleport board and the most staff point board. So feel free to watch this video if you want to learn how to make it and how we can customize it and learn about it. But first things first, if you are subscribed to my channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications. About 85% of you guys are not subscribed, which is pretty sad, but it's alright, don't worry about it. Also join the Discord in the description because we do host giveaways there, and I do help out people who ask for help, and we do have a good community going on there. But welcome everyone. So basically we are going to be doing these cafe boards. Now if you want, just go into the cafe game, or you can get this model in description by looking in the description. Look for the teleport board model and it should be this one right here. So yes, I did make a model for this, or you can just go to the cafe game, click the red three dots and just hit edit basically, and you'll be able to get this thing for you. I'll make sure it's published as well. So, of course, this is like a little cool, little weird thing to just have right here, but you can customize this all you want. So we have two boards. We're going to go over the teleport board first and then this one next, because this is a little harder than this one. So, of course, what I added is a folder called boards, and then I added a new surface GUI, which is board GUI in here. Now, if you do use the model, it's going to look like this. So you're going to get this model, and it should have this. So just put boards in workspace and put surface GUI in starter GUI, and you'll be all right. But yeah, that's all I added. What you're going to do now, you may be like, oh, Twin, this doesn't pop up right away. You're going to click this, and you're going to click Adorny, and you're going to click on the part right there. Because if I were to click on this one, it'd do that one. But we don't want that one. We want it on here. So we're going to put it right there. What we have in here is a frame, and then the description frame, and another frame, and then text button, and image label. Now, for the text button, this is the button that they're actually going to be clicking, and then we have an image label where you can change your icon, so feel free to go to image label, go to the properties down here, and just image, and you can change this to anything you'd like. So I can do this twin logo, or I can do the Twins Cafe, which thank you so much. I think it was a riff for making this. Oh my god, he's amazing. Awesome. Like, I can't believe it's amazing work. Looks amazing. But yeah, so that's basically what it looks like. And let's actually look at the script is what I was going to talk about. And I'll talk about more of the properties of this. So we have a text button. When you click on the text button in here, we have a teleport, which is script.parent. So this parent right here, teleport service. We're getting that by going to game get service, teleport service. So the teleport service is into teleport a player, place ID, and then the ID right here. So we're going to do teleport part, which is going to be basically this right here. When they click on the button, we're going to teleport them to this place. So place ID is actually just this place number right here. So just this top number, and that will teleport them to there. Now just feel free to comment in the description if this is working for you. If it isn't, I can help you out. I'm pretty sure it does just teleport one person. I wasn't able to really try with two people, but it should just teleport one person at a time. And if it doesn't, then I think the fix to that, and I'm pretty sure it does, guys, just saying again, you would just put player right here, and then you just go just player comma place ID. So that's another fix to that either way, but you know, I'll just leave that in there for now. Yeah, so that's basically that, pretty easy. Then of course we have the staff point board in here. So imply board, what you can change is the main color. So like this right here, you can change this how you'd like. You can go to the part, and inside here you can change the surface label, which then you can actually change the text properties and change to, you know, whatever you'd like. So that's another way to do that, pretty simple and fun. Then of course we have the most staff points in here, same thing as in changing colors, whatever you'd like. Then we have a union, which is going to have the main script, and then just this part right here, which is going to have the text label and the time period. You can change this how you'd like again. And of course, we have everything right here. So we have a few things. We have a scrolling frame, and then the top frame and everything else. So this is what it's going to look like. Now, customizing this is not as hard as you think. You can do colors and everything just in the properties tab, but feel free to just look at that yourself. And you basically just want to not touch anything. But if you go inside this script, so this was actually the same board that we used, but I just fixed it up and got it to work. But basically, you just want to put your stats name right here. Now, it is points for this game, so don't touch anything. But you can display how many people you want to be in ranks, like how many ranks there's going to be. So there's going to be 25. And then you can do update every 80, 60, probably do above a minute, because I'm pretty sure Data Store only updates above a minute, or else with the limits. But yeah, so that's about it. And then I can kind of go through this. So we get order Data Store service, and then we have the service UI, sample, and list. And then we have a function called get items, which is basically going to be getting the template, which is going to be that little thing, putting the player's rank, text, and color to the list. And then right here is when we're doing this whole while true do. So basically updating it, and we're basically going to grab their leader stats and update it. We're going to get the items. So we're getting it right here, updating it on the leaderboard. And then we're going to wait, and we're going to update every, which is going to be every 60 seconds as we have it. And then the canvas size is basically going to be the exact canvas size of what we have in the items. So that's about it. Now I can play this game and really quickly show you. So if I do hit play here, it's going to just pop up everything for us. Now it's actually pretty simple, because you really don't need to touch anything. I just wanted to show this for you guys. And okay, let's just definitely, I hope you can't hear that. Don't get copyright. Okay, there we go. So as you guys can tell, so when you go into here, we have the rank one player and the points. So that's pretty nice. I don't think the scrolling frame is working. I don't remember. I think it just maybe broken or not. So if it isn't, then I'll have to update that real quick. But as you can tell, when I click this, it's gonna say okay, well that's because I have the player. So yeah, probably don't do that. Player, let's not do that actually. I'll have to fix that in a second. But as you can tell, this does pop up, and this is what it's gonna look like. So we got the points and rank number one, and it will save across all servers. So about that click, let me actually just fix that real quick. I think you probably don't want to do that actually. Let me go back into Starge UI, Service UI, Board UI, Frame, just da-da-da, right here. And let's actually just remove that. And what it should say is, it should say player cannot be teleported in Roblox Studio, because yes, they cannot be teleported from Roblox Studio. So that's about it, you guys. I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, feel free to comment, subscribe, like, and share. I got a lot more videos coming, don't worry. I got some cool ideas, and I got a lot of suggestions that people are making for me, so we'll be adding a lot to this. And yes, you guys have asked me about a building kit. I am going to be having a cafe built by some fan or something. I don't know if you want to just give me your cafe. Feel free to, it'll be in this video. And I'll put it all together, basically, and it'll be pretty nice. But that's about it, you guys. If you did enjoy this video, feel free to subscribe, comment, like, and share. Like I said again, happy holidays, you guys. We're getting really near Christmas, and I'll start doing some live streams and everything for you. But yeah, you guys, I love you all so much. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.